How you doing, Fire fans? EJ Boxing live here, and we're going to discuss Floyd Mayweather and which welterweight champion with Floyd Mayweather should make Floyd Mayweather fight. So you've got a couple of them, obviously, here on the screen. So Floyd currently is the WBC and the WBA welterweight champion of the world. So that limit is the 147 division. And so the other champions are Manny Pacquiao, who's covering WBO championship, and Kell Brook is covering the IBF championship. I put Keith Thurman in there because he's supposed to be fighting. He's the interim champion. He's the interim WBA champion, which falls in line with Floyd. And basically, he's next in line to fight Floyd. But I mix him. I could see him mixing with Pacquiao and Kell, and we're gonna probably get into that a bit. But I'm gonna mostly focus on Floyd because the kind of welterweight division, and in boxing in general, right now they kind of focus on Floyd and who's gonna fight next, and it's very interesting. So now we're gonna talk about it, right. So first fight for Floyd defending his two belts, I think should be against Manny Pacquiao. I think that should be the next fight for him, right, straight away. There's no other. This is the best time for it. It's either put up or shut up. All three belts are going to be aligned. WBO, WBA, WBC belts, all online for a mega fight. Which, to be honest with you, is probably bigger now than it would be before because of all the belts online. Because at the time, Pacquiao didn't have all the belts and Floyd didn't have all the belts. So right now, that's obviously Floyd is the undisputed welterweight champion because he's done in the past, even though he's took time off. Because I remember he beat Carlos Baldomir and he beat Zab Judah at the time. And Zab Judah beat Corey Spinks, who was undisputed. And Floyd beat both of them. And then Floyd also beat Shane Mosley. Margarito beat Cotto, and he had two belts there, and keep going down. So Floyd is the guy at the division. But anyway, so for Manny Pacquiao, and he does beat Tim Bradley in a rematch, this is the perfect opportunity for them to basically, you know, Floyd is number one in the division, but just to clear up the division, and you know, Floyd can just leave at that point. So Floyd should fight Manny Pacquiao, and it'll be a great fight. So for them two to fight now, how would the fight look? I mean, this is the best look illustration of how the fight would. It'd be backwards and forwards. Manny, you know, has got a bit of confidence that back. People thought, wow, Floyd would beat him easy. He could. Or he could get seriously damaged in the fight. We don't know until they get into the ring. Is it a 50-50 fight? You might favor Floyd as the favorite. At this point, Floyd's probably a slight favorite. He didn't look overly good against Marcus Madonna. Who does? I mean, fought back-to-back with Madonna. Pacquiao didn't look good against Tim Bradley. Arguably, he won the first fight, but he definitely won the second fight. And I talked to Tim Bradley with 78 Sports TV time, and said he was just trying to knock. Tim Bradley said he was just trying to knock Pacquiao. But anyway, Pacquiao's won the fight and he's in the position, so he's the WBO champion, and he's got a fight with Chris Algieri coming up soon. So if he gets past that fight next year, 2015, maybe September, Cinco de Mayo, or whatever, Floyd and Manny Pacquiao, they should fight. So if that they fight, who'd win? Well, this would be Floyd's career and legacy and everything. Manny Pacquiao's lost and everything. He's Hall of Famer. Both of them Hall of Famers. So it's not going to tarnish the referee. But just to know who's the very best of all time and everything, it would clear things up. So I don't know who's going to win. I'd like to believe Floyd would, but I can't guarantee that. I'll roll with Floyd in a minute, but I'm not going to guarantee. There's no guarantees in that one. All right, so we move on to the next fight for Floyd in the division. Kell Brook. Yep, Kell Brook, this is the IBF champion, done fresh, beat Sean Showtime Porter, and he'd be a good fight for Mayweather. Could happen in London, happen in Vegas, wherever it is, it'd be a big fight. Both undefeated, draw. Kell's not necessarily a big personality, but he's put himself in a position where Floyd, this is a very good challenger for Floyd, you know what I mean? Kell put on a good performance against Sean Porter, where basically, you know, he won most of the majority round. Some people say, Porter won, but for me, I had Kell bring. I thought the fight was near enough for 1 point thing, and you know, Kell won by a landslide in the judges. And yeah, that would be a good fight for Floyd, man. And in the day, if that fight panned out, if they were to match up, you can see how Floyd in this illustration of them thing, but Floyd wouldn't have it easy. You know, Carroll's got long reach arms. He's arguably like a 154 pounder coming down. Very strong at the weight, give Floyd a lot of problems. Floyd has the quickness and stuff like that. He could evade some of the shots, but he could get hurt really bad in this fight here. But how the fight would, you know, okay, maybe you favor Floyd again. I mean, he would be the favorite coming into the fight because of what he's put up. But Kell would give it to him. I'm not like Kell's never lost. He's just different. It's a different thing where a guy's lost. When a guy's lost, they think they lose. Kell's never no loss. But the only thing snag in the fight is Kell has an injury. I was talking to T-Shirt. He said T-Shirt said that Kell. Somebody tried to assassinate Kell. Somebody tried to assassinate Kell when he was on holiday. Anyway, regardless of that, he has a big gash in his leg from a knife wound. So how would that affect Kell Brook going into that fight with Floyd whenever it happened? Either London, Wembley. That's a Wembley Stadium fight straight away. Or Vegas, wherever. So how would that affect Kell? That's the only thing I could say, but the fight would be very, very interesting. And that's another point for Floyd. Okay, we're gonna move on to the next one. So we're gonna go on to Keith Thurman versus Floyd Mayweather Jr. for obviously the WBA championship, which Keith Thurman has the interim one, so he's next in line. Keith Thurman, a lot of people put a lot of stock behind Keith Thurman, but he hasn't fought anyone up at Mayweather's level. But this would be the acid test for him, and we'll see how much Mayweather had left if Mayweather, this was to be Mayweather's next fight. I'm not too sure how this fight would pan out, but I know it'd be very interesting because Keith Thurman is very explosive. Again, he's an undefeated fighter; he's never lost before. Floyd's an undefeated fighter; he's never lost before. He's going to be young as well. He's bringing a lot of energy, but you know, Floyd's been there, done it, a lot of experience. Would Floyd be the favorite coming into the fight? Slightly. Keith Thurman is the danger man of the division, and no one really wants to fight him. It'd be a really good fight, explosive fight, and someone could get it out, or someone could be schooled. Either way you can pick, you're not going to be wrong. So that's an opponent for Floyd. We're going to talk about cover Kell Brook a bit slightly now. Kell Brook, yeah. This has been a needle inside against Amir Khan. Now, Amir Khan has stepped up in the welterweight division. He beat Louis Collazo on points. He knocked Louis Collazo down a couple of times as well. Obviously, Kell beat Sean Porter. Did be a good fight in London. And obviously, you see Eddie Hearn in the background. Did be a really good fight. I think maybe Kell would win, but there's no guarantee. Amir Khan has quick hands, long, quick, but he doesn't fight like that no more. He fought like that when he was with Freddie Roach, and he was more flat-footed now. Tried parry shots, and that's the wrong thing to do if you want to fight Kell. He needs to be on his toes when he's fighting Kell. And if they was to get in the ring, it would be very, very interesting. Very, very interesting how that fight would. I mean, Kell has enough power to give Khan a whole heap of trouble, you know. He can give him a whole heap of trouble. So I really do like that fight. I think if Khan can move around and use his foot speed, give Kell trouble and peck him, he could probably win on points. But if Kell's trying to win, Kell will be trying to blast him out. Regardless, it'll be a very entertaining fight. Just because Kell's the champion, he'll be the slight champion for that favorite for that fight. And so move on to another one. This would be another interesting battle of the undefeated. Keith one time Thurman versus the special one, Kell Brook. Now that fight there, very good, very good. Yeah, again to battle undefeated. They've never lost then in the welterweight division. Like I said, it's a lot of big money fight. I think it's a Vegas fight. If Keith Thurman come to London, Eddie Hearn will make it a big thing. And especially with De La Hoya and Al Haymon, they'd make it a massive thing. I don't know if De La Hoya actually be interested about in this fight, but like wherever the fight is, it'll be a big fight. When it's finished promoting, if they try and make it a thing, it's definitely a pay-per-view fight. Definitely pay-per-view fight. People pay money to see that fight. To see if Keith Thurman is the truth. Is he like what most people think he is, the danger man? And Kell, see if Kell can solidify himself as one of the elite guys. So that, I like that fight. You know, if you see them fighting, it'll be that ebbs and flows. someone, the way them two hit hard, someone probably get knocked out. Kel could be exposed, leave himself open, and Keith could hurt him. Or Keith could be exposed and Kel could hurt him. You never know in that fight. So that would be a really good fight for the fight fans, and I'd love to see that fight. But going back to the start again, like I said, Floyd Mayweather fighting all these champions, fight to fight the best champions right now. These are the ones. So Floyd versus Manny, I feel that'll be the number one thing, obviously, in the world division. The next fight, Kell Brook, that'll be the second best option for him, or Keith Thurman, right? And you can mix them up. You could have maybe Manny versus Kell, Manny versus Thurman, you know, mix them up. You could mix them up, the four of them. Between the four, you'll have great fights. You have basically two undefeated fighters. You have two all-time great Hall of Famers between Manny Pacquiao and Floyd Mayweather. And you can't go wrong either way. Any of them four fights right there are going to be great. So, yeah. So, anyways, that's my take on the welterweight division. So, who should Floyd fight next? Leave your comments in the comment section. I'm EJ Boxing Live, and I'll catch you on the next one. All right, peace.